years I go wandering once again, back to the seasons of my youth. I recall a box of rags that someone gave us, and how my mama put the rags to every piece was small, and I didn't have a coat, and it was way down in the fall. Mama sewed the rags together, sewing every piece with love. She made my coat of many colors that I was so proud of. As she sewed, she told the story from the Bible she had read, about a coat of many colors Joseph wore. And then she said, perhaps this coat will bring you good luck and happiness. And I just couldn't wait to wear it, and Mama blessed it with a kiss. My coat of many colors that my mama made for me, made only from rags, but I wore it so proudly. Although we had no money, I was rich as I could be in my coat of many colors. My mom on my breeches and holes in both my shoes, in my coat of many colors, I hurried off to school just to find the others laughing and making fun of me. In my coat of many colors, my mom with more than all their clothes. They didn't understand it, and I tried to make them see that one is only poor, only if they choose to be. I know we had no money, but I was rich as I
Welcome, everyone, to our fellowship for today, Sunday service. We're so happy to have you with us this last Sunday in January. And next Sunday, we'll be welcoming you all in person at the Red Cedar Friends Quaker Meeting House in Old Town. Please remember that we'll also be live streaming it from there as well. So join us in person or watch online, either way that's more comfortable for you. But we welcome you here today, and we're so grateful to have you with us. So let's begin this afternoon by doing our opening meditation together. I invite you to close your eyes, and let's just relax our bodies. Let your shoulders drop and put your feet flat on the floor. And let's take two deep breaths together. Breathing in and a big release out. One more breathing in and relaxing with that out breath. Just follow your breath. And maybe put your hand on your heart to bring our attention into our heart center. In this moment, we surrender. We surrender this human body and this ego mind. And we ground ourselves right now in this moment in our true nature, one with the undefinable, unbounded, unlimited divine. Seeing and feeling the comfort and warmth and the brilliance of our divine light within. Hearing the sweet and gentle song of divine love in our hearts. We are realigned and revived and rejuvenated, free to be all that we are, and free to share all that we are. Pure, true love. Resting here in the unlimited blessings of grace, we affirm that all is well. And together we say, and so it is, and so it is. Thank you so much. I have a reading for you today from, you know, my favorite book, The Book of Awakening by Mark Nepo. He writes, "It seems there are two basic ways to feel the fullness of life, and both arise from the authenticity of our relationships. One is from our love of life, and the other is from our love of each other. Often in our solitude, we can discover the miracles of life if we take the time and risk to be alone until the glow of life presents itself. This is the reward of all meditation. It's like taking the path of our aloneness deep enough through the woods so we can reach that unspoiled clearing. We can also reach that unspoiled clearing by taking the time and risk to be thoroughly with each other. And this is the reward of love. But our most frequent obstacle to experiencing the fullness of life, which I have suffered many times, is the hesitancy that keeps us from being either fully alone with life or fully alone with each other. Being half anywhere is the true beginning of loneliness."
I'm going to sing Simple Man by Lynyrd Skynyrd, and I hope you enjoy it and get something out of it, although I know it's quite unconventional to do Lynyrd Skynyrd for a spiritual center. I think it has a really good message.
Mama told me when I was young, come come sit beside me, my only son, and listen closely to what I say. And if you do this, it'll help you some sunny day. Oh yeah. Oh, take your time, don't live too fast. Troubles will come and they will pass. You'll find a woman, yeah, you'll find love. And don't forget, son, there's someone up above. And be a simple kind of man. Oh, be something you love and understand. Baby, be a simple kind of man. Won't you do this for me, son, if you can? Forget your lust for the rich man's gold. All that you need is in your soul. And you can do this, oh baby, if you try. All that I want for you, my son, is to be satisfied and be a simple something you love and understand. Baby, be a simple kind of man. Won't you do this for me, son, if you can? Boy, don't you worry, you'll find yourself. Follow your heart and nothing else. And you can do this, oh baby, if you try. All that I want for you, my son, is to be satisfied. Be something you love and understand. Baby, be a simple kind of man. Won't you do this for me, son, if you can? Baby, be a simple, be a simple man. Oh, be something. Baby, be a simple kind of man. Won't you do this for me, son, if you can?
Right now, we bring our attention to the blessing of our tithes and offerings. And so let's just become quiet within and remember that we share so many blessings and so much abundance in our lives. And we're so grateful to all of you for your generous donations to the fellowship. So I invite you now to read with me our blessing of the tithes and offerings. You'll see the words right here on the screen. The light of divine love shines eternally, blessing and multiplying our tithes and offerings. I joyously give, knowing I always have enough to share and to spare. Thank you again. And now we're excited because we have something really different this afternoon. And it's an experience. So let's settle in and listen to our Greater Lansing area drummers and the message that Michelle Leonard brings us.
Hi, I'm Michelle Leonard, and I'm the host and organizer of the Greater Lansing Area Drummers. I got this group together in 2019, and the reason was I'm really passionate about music. I've been playing music all my life, basically, and I took piano lessons for 10 years. I've been writing music since the 80s, and I play piano, I play hammered dulcimer and drums and percussion. The first time the first drum I ever bought was back in 2006. And I bought a djembe, and I'd never played drums before. I always wanted to. And I just learned, I taught myself to play. And a couple years later, a friend of mine introduced me to a drum circle, a local drum circle in the Detroit area. And I started going to that, and it was just the most fun I'd ever had. It was just so much fun, and it just got me hooked, basically. And what happened was I was moving around Michigan for a while and ended up in this area in Bath, Michigan, and there wasn't a drum circle around in the local area, and I really missed it. So. It took me a few years to get it together, but I went to the Bath Parks and Recreation Department, and we started the drum circle in September of 2019. And then 6 months later, the pandemic happened. So we were, we were in quarantine during that time for a couple of months. But then we started back up. We were meeting every week on Saturday. I think it was Saturdays or Sundays. And we started back up in, I think it was April or May, started going over to Lake Lansing Park North. And we just kept it going. And it was just really a big blessing to keep being able to meet and gather. Drum circles are a really great way to bring people together in community, to meet people you've never met before, and just to have a lot of fun with music. I think a lot of people in our society feel that they can't play music, or they're conditioned to think that they're not musical, and I just don't believe that. I think everybody has music in them. We all have a heartbeat, and it's that primal, primordial rhythm that we tap into when we're in the drum circle. I really believe in breaking down the boundaries between audience and performer. And in a drum circle, there is no audience. We're all the performers, we're all the co-creators. Drum circles really break down the boundaries between audience and performer. I really believe in that because I think in our society, we don't really have opportunities to experience music in that way. There's a dynamic that there's, we're usually looking at a band performing on stage and we're in the audience like observers, but a drum circle allows everybody to contribute and to experience participating in music creation. I had a really dramatic experience of this once when I was at a yoga festival up north. I was in the audience and there was a performer who was ready to start singing, and I was sitting there listening to this beautiful music while I was waiting for the drum circle to start. And I had this conflict because I started to hear the drums starting over on the hill. And I thought to myself, well, I can either sit here and listen to this beautiful music, or I can go and join the drum circle on the hill. And the drums won out. And I ran over there with my drums and got into the celebration around the bonfire. Everybody was dancing and drumming, and it was just awesome. And in that moment, I ceased to be a passive observer. I was an active participant. It's a totally different experience. So when you get a really large group of people together, it can really almost be transcendent, because I think something happens with our brains almost that it's almost like being in meditation, where everybody's kind of syncing up together and you're in kind of a group mind or a group consciousness thing. It can be very powerful. It can be really powerful. So that's a really special experience that you can have in a drum circle, but it's also just, you know, like I said, good to come together with other people in community, have an experience with other people that maybe you have never met before. It's also got really positive health benefits. It activates the immune system. It's good for people who have depression or anxiety. It stimulates cells in the body that are like anti-cancer cells. So there's lots of benefits to group drumming. And it's just a really fun and amazing experience. And you don't have to have a musical background. Lots of people who are musicians enjoy drum circles, but you can be a beginner and you can get right into it. It doesn't take music theory or music lessons or a musical background. Everybody is welcome, and we're a really friendly group. We meet every week at the Fledge in the winter time, on Sundays from 2 to 4. In the warm weather, we're usually over at Greater Lansing. Lake Lansing Park North in Hazlitt. And throughout history, different cultures throughout the world have used drumming and music and dance to come together for community events like marriages and religious and spiritual celebrations. And it's something that we don't really do in our everyday lives to that degree, where the whole community is participating in the music making. Usually if you go to a wedding, there's like a DJ or something, and there's a performer and audience dynamic again. So there's a big history to drumming, and it's something that people have been doing for thousands of years. There was a master drummer by the name of Babatunde Olatunji, and he was a Nigerian djembe master who came to this country in the 50s, I believe, and he connected with a lot of jazz and rock musicians, and he's really the father of the drum circle. That has grown, the movement has grown over the decades. So he's somebody that we bow down to in gratitude for starting this whole movement of drumming and group drumming and celebration and music making together. Again, we're the Greater Lansing Area Drummers. Everybody's welcome, families are welcome, kids are welcome. We're a very friendly group, and we'd love to have you join us sometime. Thank you.
I'm going to play a song for you that I love so much. It's called Oh What a World by Kacey Musgraves. And this song is acknowledging what a beautiful, amazing, magical, and mysterious world that we live in. And of all the things that we have to be amazed by, there's you.
Mm-hmm.
northern lights in our skies, plants that grow and open your mind, things that swim with a neon glow, how we all got here, nobody knows, these are real things, yeah, these are real things, oh. Did I know you once in another life? Are we here just once or a billion times? Well, I wish I knew, but it doesn't matter, 'cause you're here right now and I know what I feel. And these are real things. Yeah, these are real things. Oh, what a world. Don't wanna leave. All kinds of magic all around us. It's hard to believe. Thank God. These are real things. Yeah, these are real things. Oh, what a world. All kinds of magic. Tell me it's not too good to be true. Oh, what a world. And then there is you.
What a great service this afternoon. Thank you so much to Amber Cordell for her wonderful music, for sharing that with us. Thank you to Michelle Leonard and the Greater Lansing Area Drummers for sharing your drumming experience with us today. I especially what resonated with me is this idea of drumming as a whole body experience that really connects us as co-creators at that very deep level of the primal heartbeat. It really inspired me, and I think I'm going to want to have that experience myself. So if you're interested in joining in one of the drumming circles that they provide at the Fledge or outside when the weather gets better, we'll be sharing all the details in our e-announcements coming up on Tuesday. I also want to thank all of our speakers and musicians over the last 2 years during this time of COVID and all of our virtual services for so generously sharing with us. We've had speakers from all over the country and also musicians from all over the country sharing their music, and we have been able to do that because of the services being virtual, and everyone has been so very generous. So thank you again, all of you, from our hearts. The fellowship has enjoyed your music and your messages, and we appreciate you so much. I also want to thank all of you today for being here this afternoon and reminding everyone once again that we will be welcoming you all at the Red Cedar Friends Meeting House in Old Town next Sunday, It's going to require us to create new habits and, you know, get out there and come together and enjoy our group energy in person. And again, if you are not able to join us in person, we'll continue to live stream the services on Facebook. The affirmation I have for you this afternoon is this: I am fully present. I am fully present. And we can use this, we can repeat this when we catch ourselves habitually slipping into the past or the future, and just bring ourselves right back to this very beautiful present moment where everything happens. I am fully present. And now it's time for forming our big virtual peace circle. Let's stand up if you're able and stretch out your arms and hold your neighbor's hand in yours as we sing our peace song and say our closing blessing at the end. Thank you again for joining us all these Sundays for the virtual services. And we look forward to seeing you next Sunday in person if you're able.